All right. Who's ready to bolt and nut? Don't take that out of context. I failed, you guys. I failed the challenge. Banjo, a rather loud bird called Kazooie, and an unpleasant witch called Gruntilda. When Banjo's sister was kidnapped, the bear and bird rescued her from the depths of the witch's lair, overcoming many perils and speech impediments to send Gruntilda tumbling to her doom. But she was nothing if not persistent, and surprising nobody, the old hag soon rose from her grave for round two. Our brave heroes once again stood in her way, and this second showdown ended just as...
I really do appreciate having 8 minutes to myself before the run starts. Allows me to take a seat back, sip my water, and then proceed to not do that for 2 hours. And the witch.
You know, it's weird you bring that up, Bowser. I, you know, before my Pizza Tower submission, I originally planned to, like, write out what I was gonna say during the run. But then I just ended up, like, getting a really nice PB and just thought it was fine. And funnily enough, it worked out. Now, am I saying, do you need to have a script ready? I mean, you can have one. I just don't think it's necessary. There's a lot of factors that go into a submission, man. I personally think if you're just an entertaining person, it'll be just fine. And that's why I think my original submission with Pizza Tower did so well. You know, new game aside. That's fair. Now, the one thing I think I suck at personally is, you know, explaining the game I'm playing. That was probably the one takeaway I took from my GDQ run. I wasn't good at communicating my run that well, but I was good at least, you know, playing the part. Yo, thanks, Aces. Appreciate it.
Oh,
Fair enough. I don't know if it's the games I play, but trying to commentate and explain the runs while running the game itself is very hard for me. Probably because 80% of my brain is on the game, so, you know, the only thing you'll get out of me is a lot of ums and uhs, but you know that already. Also, R.I.P. Lucky. I mean, it's a skill, Lucky. A skill that a lot of people can't really master. And to be fair, it's easier in some games. A game like Pizza Tower, it's really hard. And I think we can all understand why. This is up there too, but for different reasons. Yeah, that too. It's next to impossible in Pizza Tower. The only real breather you get to just read chat in general is just like... Honestly, I would say the elevator segments. And maybe like the couple second intermissions you get whenever you like defeat a boss where it plays the jingle, so... No shot. That is mind-blowing, actually. Like, just being able to just interact with your chat like that through text in Pizza Tower of all games. You know how hard that is? Bro has to alt-tab, type his sentence, and get back into the game in like a span of like... Like, at most, 3 or 4 seconds. True. Strong couches are a good foundation. I didn't really have that much of a couch last time. It was mostly just friends. And I didn't mind that. But if I went to GDQ again, I probably would want an actual couch. Ellie was the only person I brought from the Pizza Tower community. And I think the one person that ended up doing the most talking outside of me was Shay, which I added for just, you know, a bit of comical flair. Oh my god, ah. Yes! What's up, Lance? Welcome to the best speedrun ever. People hate this game, and I'm like one of the few people that loves it. So, I'm happy you're in the same boat as me. 100% Lance. Probably doesn't help that I never grew up with the original 2D Banjo games, so my bias to those is non-existent. I just enjoy this game as it is. Happy to hear we're in agreement. Okay, that? Okay, that's not gonna work. Anyway, I need to be quiet here. This is the hardest part of the run. We're trying a new setup this time, at least with the second prop surf. Did that land? I gotta do it again. Great. Sloth failed, you guys. He failed. Point and laugh. Now we can even do an even better lineup. Oh my god, I need these rhinos to go away. Thank you. I guess it works for now. Fuck it. Anyway, if you're curious, Lance, the first, like, 20 minutes is us basically prop surfing everywhere in Showdown Town to get all the late-game parts, and then it's a non-stop dash through all the missions until we get 75 Jiggies. We also need to grab a couple of notes, just to buy like 5 free jiggies, like after Nutty Acres 3, I believe. That was not the best lineup. It's okay. Let's not do this now. You will stay on the cart. So here's the funny thing about it, actually. So, any percent allows you to use blueprints of all kinds. So, and the way that new games work is basically, all your blueprints that you make will carry over to new save files. It's just a matter of getting the parts. So once we get all the parts we need, it's basically anything goes. And I have over 30 pre-built vehicles. Let me tell you, out of all the speedruns I have done over the years, this one took the most preparation. And it, in my opinion, it was worth it. This should be a fine enough lineup. That should be fine, right? Good news, it was fine. Doing everything in my power not to spill this thing. Alright, we're good. And now we get to break the game. And we're gonna be grabbing one more crate here for some more vehicles later down the line. And now we're going to Nutty Acres 2. I will say, though, there is a couple missions we do that just use preset vehicles anyway, and they're still arguably some of the fastest missions, so you're hoping for something right away. I am sorry. I assure you, the next one is where it starts. There's this really funny mission in Nutty Acres 4 where there's like an escort mission. You probably remember the one. And we actually ended up just carrying him to the goal instead of just, you know, following him around with a vehicle that can, you know, do damage. Arguably, like, top three mission for me to show. It really is. That is normal Vroom. Oh my. This is gonna be a time loss. Surprised I didn't switch to F Room when I did this first mission. That's why it caught me off guard. I missed. This is really bad. Let go. Fuck, I don't see him anywhere. We might have to reload this. Okay, no, he's up there. That's good. I was worried he wasn't. Ah, you did not. I'm like one off, aren't I? It's 125. I'm six off, actually. Okay. That's bad on my part, but I could have sworn I actually had enough. Alright, well, we're losing a lot here. Rough start, but I'll tolerate it for now. Actually, it might be because I did Act 2 of Nutty Acres a bit differently. Alright, well, you know what? 40 seconds is not that bad. Fun fact, a lot of these are names that the community has used just in general. I've only renamed a few. Yeah. All right, time for this ass of a mission. Oh, hi, Kyoshi. What's up? Thank you for the raid. Appreciate it. Welcome, raiders. I'm Soaring Sloth. I speedrun all kinds of shit. And right now, it happens to be the funny banjo game that a lot of people have mixed opinions about. Enjoy your stay. And yes, you should totally go follow Kyoshi. Kyoshi does a lot of Amori runs. Good friend of mine. And fellow One Piece enjoyer. Very important detail. Thank you. I got so nervous with some of those, lineups. Also, thank you, Mosses, for the 100 bits. Really appreciate that. If it isn't obvious, this game requires a lot of focus, so if I don't keep up with the chat, I apologize. Also, I did not unlock that. I need to unlock it. That's a bad lineup. Yo, what's up, Link? Also, no worries, Aubrey. It happens to the best of us. Either way, welcome. Wait. There we go. Oh no, I killed him. I'm so sorry. I did not mean that. No. Bad lineup. Dude, what is up with this traction today? Okay. I was so certain it was going to be just fine. But then bump into everybody leaving, into me exiting the fucking vehicle. Okay. Oh my god, land on there, please. Thank you. Hi, Batman. Welcome to the stream. I play a lot of Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. I also might be a little bit insane, but you're not supposed to say that to new viewers. It tends to scare people. Me too. You think it's Purple Flirt from Jimmy Neutron? I like to believe it is. I don't know, Purple Flirt was pretty crazy in Jimmy Neutron. Like, genuinely. No, you don't. Okay. I don't know. All I know is, you know, little me would have killed to have a can of Purple Flirt. I failed to do the one thing I... Oh my, okay. Go with the third one. Okay, now I'm definitely gonna have to. Oh, it's here. Jay, thank you for the 6 months, Ellie. Your words truly inspire everybody, including myself. Next month, you will say the next letter of the alphabet. I pressed the button and it just did not register. You love to see it. It's kind of like becoming a joke now that I still haven't watched the live-action One Piece show, and I really need to. My friends are, like, hammering me to do so. But that's the only thing on my radar right now. Yeah, 8 episodes, all an hour long. Oh my god, I have the worst. Turn around. Banjo, you're doing the exact opposite of turning around. Thank you. Close enough. I will take this setup. Why is there so many rhinos? I've actually heard it's really good. Yeah, like Netflix actually made a fucking good live action anime adaptation. I mean, to be fair, I know it's got Oda's blessing, and like I think every single episode had 17 million going into it. Like, I think the craziest thing about it is that one of my friends that was really not into One Piece at all, like, they used to shit on it a lot, is actually really interested in the live action and is now interested in watching the, like, the fucking original anime, which is so funny to me. Because I'm just like, dude, this is it. This is it. This is how I convert my friends to, like, get into One Piece. I mean, if it's anything, I know it's mostly East Blue stuff, so if you got to episode 40, you're probably going to be treading familiar ground. Like, it's basically a different take on everything you've seen, from what I've heard. Like, I was actually talking about this with Leon, not even too long ago, but, oh my god, please. Oh, okay, I have to restart. I hate this script so much. It's like if I don't grab this thing the right way, it always goes in that corner and I can't get him out of there. So. But anyway, I was talking about it literally just an hour ago with Leon, and like apparently like people like Kobe and Garp actually get a lot more screen time in this iteration than they do in like just like the manga or the anime, which is fucking crazy to me because do you know how much screen time they even get in those adaptations? They hardly get anything. Like, you only learn more about Garp and Kobe, like, way down the line. Also, excuse me? He really went over the goal. I think you're on to something. The only thing ice does for me is refrigerate my food and make my beverages cold. Me too. Watered down soda is actually awful. And this is coming from somebody that hardly even drinks soda. Also, I dude, there's so many red names in my chat. I did not even notice Shovel was in the chat. Hi. If you're still here, hello. So chew. I mean, I'm happy everybody is in agreement that red is, like, the best color. But fuck, it makes it really hard sometimes to actually see who's in the chat. Really? I guess I'm actually kind of cut off guard by that. Holy shit. Well, in that case, what is your favorite color? Blue, base. Blue is probably number two for me, so. Oh my god, I missed three rings. What am I doing? Very comical. Are they actually? I know it can, like, also vary a bit from user to user. Like, you know, from, like, my perspective, you know, it could just be three reds. But, like, on another person's perspective, it could just be, like, you know, like, one person's blue, one person's purple. But maybe that's just something I've experienced. I just know whenever I refresh the page sometimes on Twitch, like, colors will change. Yeah, maybe. don't know, someone in chat probably knows it better than I do. I've just kind of noticed it over the years. And maybe it's been discontinued. That was the fastest I've ever done that mission. I'm really proud of that. It's pretty solid so far. A bit of up and downs, but... you know, the offline practice I've been doing, it's showing. It wouldn't let me detach it for some reason, but it's still good. Oh boy. Okay, I finessed that. Good, 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 good. Cowabunga! Oh god. Oh, come on. Okay. That would have been a gold if I didn't mess up the end there. That sucks. But I was already, like, kind of caught off guard with the fact that I genuinely just missed the target somehow. Damn it. That's gonna be a bet. Ayo, what'd you smed? Over the edge? All I'm saying is, you know, I didn't anticipate myself to get in, and if you get in, I'm pulling up. Good. Honestly, this it literally goes like both ways, all right? If Nuts and Bolts somehow gets in, your couch spot is secured. Thank you. I was worried that was not gonna work. Oh, don't say that. Over the hedges, S tier. People just haven't noticed it yet. Oh god. Good. This might not be enough. Barely. Whew. Yeah, I'll check it out. Sorry. You know me, I tend to forget things. Myself. Too fast. I will land this first try. Wow, I landed it first try. Oh no, I don't like this lineup. Okay. In a different reality, that police car would have tipped me over. And I'm thankful it didn't. Oh my god, get out of the way. Pedestrians, am I right? What the fuck? Okay. Oh, Man said I'm a ping pong ball today. Okay, now I'm mad. Out of all the racing missions in this game, this is probably one of the easiest. So kind of just missing two rings on it. It's kind of like, bro, really? There's not even that many rings. Like, it's mostly just five, and then it's just this sprint to the sixth. I just... Yeah, okay. I don't. A little too silly coded for sloth. Are you kidding me? Okay. Fucking why? Let's try to get that again. Can I even scoop them up? I can't. That right there. That's aggravating. Only because I have the giant doohickey and I can't do the thing with the giant doohickey because there just happens to be the most irregular surface possible. Out. This was indeed a level. A level that I will still dislike in the speedrun. That! Man! I thought I was one short. That guy literally just ran at me. It's a miracle I didn't lose that. Come on. Okay, thanks. Really appreciate that. Can I? I can't fly. The control's too bad. I can't. Of course I got stuck on this. And, of course, cool. You fuck! Okay. I hate that he did that twice. Okay. I mean, it doesn't really matter this late into the game, because just like I saw in last PB, all of it is on Grunty at the very end. If I can just hold out and just do all right on Grunty, we're in, so. fucking hell. Welcome back, Ellie. Welcome to the last leg of the run. You fuck. Every 10% of the time, that doesn't work. And man, does it hurt. Thank you. call. So close. Oh my God. Shirley. There we go. This camera. Literally, they are a social construct. Lance gets it. Thank you. Alright, well, again, this run is definitely going to come down to Grunty once more, so... As long as we just have an okay one, we'll PB. Unless I fail to get to the first of two missions. Alright. Can't say I've had that happen before. Okay. This is the worst case scenario. All right. Bro, literally it just went flying too. Caught me off guard. Me too. They are the innocent bystanders. Thank you. I actually just juked them all. I love it. What's up, Jank Pickle? Welcome to the final mission of the run, where I might go insane. Because, oh my god, is it unfair. Gather around, everybody, as I will comically drown Grunty not once, not twice, not three times, not four times, but five times! Did not drop, all right. We at least got a good grip, even on the backup, so. Camera, what are you doing? We go this way. Thank you. All right, most important one. In the water. Oh my god. We actually fucking got it. Dude, I cannot express how fucking hard it is to first try that. Oh my god. We did it. Sub 2 hours, everybody. I have broken the 2 hour barrier at long last. And by 5 minutes, no less. Phew, fuck. And this room was actually crazy overall. I noticed a lot of just small improvements all around. Like, this was... I need to check the splits individually. How many golds overall? Three, four... Four, five... 6, 7, 8, 11 golds. And I know there were some pretty meaty golds in the mix, too. Like, it wasn't just, like, a couple seconds for each. I'd argue we probably saved another 2 minutes off of best possible time. I'm in a good mood now. Shit. If it wasn't for the fact that I'm working, like, almost 40 hours this week, I'd probably run this back again, but it's also 9 to 45 and I gotta wake up for work tomorrow at 8, so... I'll let credits roll and probably find somebody to raid again. Meantime, though, this is definitely going to be a Twitter post. Proud of this one. This one's doing numbers. $153.34 IGT. Yeah, that's a spicy one, all right.